once again, everybody. God is mighty. He is great. He is merciful. And he deserves our praise. So, Lord, open our lips and open our lives to you today. Amen. Presence, you are omnipresent, you are with us, and you are for us. So help us to put your hope in our hope in your name, no matter what the circumstance. Turn around for good, Lord.
Turn it around, all of my own is in the name. God, turn it around. God, turn it around. God, turn it around.
Trusting you today. Amen.
Good morning and welcome to worship. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Today we celebrate the 22nd Sunday after Pentecost. We are looking more closely at our gospel lesson for today, which takes us back to the ancient city of Jericho, where we meet a man by the name of Bartimaeus, who cries out to Jesus, "Have mercy on me." And in love, Jesus does. We learn from our gospel lesson a little more about the merciful love of Jesus and the gift of faith that brings us so many blessings. May God strengthen us in our faith in Jesus, in our worship today, as we sing his praises, bring our prayers to him, and hear his word of gracious love for us. Let's begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We speak responsibly, Psalm 126. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion,
we were like those who dream.
Then our mouth was filled with laughter,
and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations,
the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord.
Like streams in the Negeb,
those who sow in tears
shall reap with shouts of joy.
He who goes out weeping, bearing the seed for sowing,
shall come home with shouts of joy, bringing his sheaves with him.
Glory be to the Father,
and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now,
and will be forever.
Amen.
The Old Testament reading is from Jeremiah chapter 31. Thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, O Lord, save your people, the remnants of Israel. Behold, I will bring them from the north country, and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, the pregnant woman and she who is in labor, together a great company, they shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with pleas for mercy I will lead them back. I will make them walk by brooks of water in the straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I am a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everybody. Today's object lesson comes from Mark 10:46-52. And in this passage, we hear a story of Jesus, and he's making his way through Jericho with all of his disciples. And everyone in Jericho is so excited to see Jesus. So it draws a pretty large crowd. But everyone's very respectful of Jesus, so they're just calm, cool, and collected off to the side. But there's one man, Bartimaeus, who's really excited to see Jesus. He's heard of all the good things that he's done. So he's shouting his name, Jesus, Jesus! Son of David, Jesus. And everyone's like, Bartimaeus, calm down. Jesus doesn't have time for you. Stop making such a big fiasco of everything. Because you also need to keep in mind that Bartimaeus was blind. He couldn't see. And back in those days, a lot of people thought that if you had any kind of disability, that was God's way of punishing you for your sins. So a lot of people didn't think that Bartimaeus was worth Jesus's time. So they're like, Bartimaeus, just calm down. Jesus doesn't have time for you. And Bartimaeus didn't care. He kept saying, Jesus, Jesus, have mercy on me. And it worked because Jesus heard him and he told his disciples, bring that man to me, bring him over here. Oh, Bartimaeus was so excited. He jumped on up, he took his cloak off, and he ran to Jesus. And Jesus said, what do you want me to do for you? And keep in mind, Bartimaeus, he didn't have a lot of money. He didn't have a lot of food. He probably didn't have a good shelter to live in. So he could have asked for a lot of things, but the one thing he told Jesus he wanted, he said, Jesus, all I want is to be able to see. I want my eyesight back. And just like that, Jesus said, okay, Bartimaeus, you can see now. Your faith in me has healed you. So Bartimaeus just kept rejoicing and rejoicing, and he had faith in Jesus. And because of this, Jesus listened to him, and Jesus healed him. Jesus is always listening, so we shouldn't be afraid to make noise and rejoice in his name. Jesus is always listening, and he always wants to hear what's going on in our lives, what he can do for us. Jesus wants to give. But we also need to remember that Jesus has a plan. So if we're ever praying and we're talking to God and we say, Jesus, I want this. Jesus, please help me with that. if he doesn't help us right away, we need to keep in mind that Jesus does have a plan for us. And so maybe later down the line, that's when your prayers will be answered. But he is always listening. Don't think he's not, because Jesus is always listening. He wants us to make noise. He wants to hear us. Let's pray. God, we thank you for all of your love and for always listening. We thank you for hearing our prayers and taking action and helping us live out our best lives through you. In your name we pray. Amen.
Let us declare our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Sometimes the most important thing we can say is, have mercy on me, Jesus, a sinner. And when we do that with a contrite heart, when we do that with authenticity, he promises to come in and rescue us and forgive us and cleanse us. Thank you so much for your mercy, Jesus. Mercy, mercy, bring me to my knees. As the morning calls to light the dark in me, heaven's story, breathing life into my bone. Spirit, lift me from this wasteland. Mercy, mercy, now engraved upon never forget the wonders of your mercy and grace. Amen.
The Holy Gospel, according to St. Mark, the 10th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. They came to Jericho, and as Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a great crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind beggar, the son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." And many rebuked him, telling him, "Be silent." But he cried out all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." And Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." And throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. And Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" And the blind man said to him, "Rabbi, let me recover my sight." And Jesus said to him, "Go your way, your faith has made you well." And immediately he recovered his sight and followed him on the way. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O God, Christ.
Dearly loved and precious children of God, brothers and sisters in Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Our text for today is from St. Paul's letter to the Romans, the 14th chapter, verses 8 and 9. Paul wrote, "For if we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living." This is our text. Well, I don't know about you, but to be honest, I am just about completely ready to give up following the news anymore. Every day it is a new crisis. And on social media, every minute there is a new post or a new issue to be upset about. I know in my heart that that's really nothing new. And I don't think this year is an apocalyptic year necessarily, any more than any other. But boy, it just seems like it is overwhelming at times. And yet, as the writer to the Ecclesiastes said, there is nothing new under the sun. What has been before, and what we see has already been. Throughout all of human history, in spite of our advances in technology and knowledge, despite our best efforts, we have not been able to eradicate evil from the world. We simply live in a fallen world. St. John wrote in 1 John 5 that the whole world is under the control of the evil one. That is, the whole world living apart from the grace of God in Christ Jesus. You see, that is not the whole story. What John wrote from his perspective is certainly correct. The world without Christ is lost and experiencing the depths and the pain and the agony of fallenness, rebellion, and selfishness. But Jesus, our Lord himself, declared, "In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." We know that there is no lack of trouble in the world. We hear about it every day. We struggle with it every minute. But we can take heart because the Lord of the universe, the King of all creation, is in control. And we are the Lord's. Or as the New International Version puts it, we belong to the Lord. And our gracious Lord has given us his word, his promise, so that we can know with certainty that he loves us and that we can live in trusting faith in him and not in cowering fear of the world in which we live. As a matter of fact, this year, as much or more than ever, we can know that in life and in death, through pandemic and politics, in the midst of fires and earthquakes and hurricanes, whether facing temptations, trials, or tribulations, we are the Lord's. And we live in the sure and confident hope of the good and gracious promises of God. St. Paul confirmed our confidence in God when he wrote, "If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's." What an incredible, grace-filled promise for the people of God. Paul was declaring that when we are the Lord's, that relationship of belonging makes all the difference in life and in death and whatever may come our way. Being the Lord's is a relationship of belonging. It is being a child of God, by God's plan and purpose, by his design and grace, by his calling and spirit, beginning with the splash of baptismal waters, as our name was called from the heights of heaven in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, God through his word and by his spirit pulled us into his arms and into his heart. You are my beloved child. You belong to me. And from this point on, come what may, you are mine. It is a relationship of belonging that endures throughout our earthly lives and indeed forever into eternity. Whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. Wherever we are, whatever we face, wherever we walk, whatever troubles or afflictions or struggles we bear, we are the Lord's. Paul went on in the next verse to explain why this relationship of belonging is even possible for us. "For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be the Lord, both of the dead and of the living." Christ, by his own death and resurrection, secured for us by his work that which we could never attain on our own, by our own works. He has secured for us an identity in Christ as children of God by Christ's work on our behalf, by his living in our place under the law, his dying the death that we deserve, and his rising again in victory on the third day. He has secured for us a relationship with our Father in heaven through his Son, Jesus Christ, in the power of the Spirit that will indeed endure forever. We do not live alone, and we do not die alone. We do not face our struggles alone, and we do not wrestle with powers and principalities, pandemics and politics, trials and tribulations alone. For we are the Lord's, And the Lord is with us and for us today, tomorrow, and always. No matter what challenges we may face in our lives, and no matter when or how our deaths may come, Christ is the Lord of both, and we belong to Him. As God's children, we have confidence in life, and we have peace in death, for we are the Lord's, both now and forever. In this difficult and long, long year, what better news can we bring to the world around us? What better gift can we offer to our neighbors than the gift of hope and life, of confidence and peace in Christ who died for all and rose again to give the victory of life to all, now and forever? As people look to us to be a listening ear, a caring heart, a hand of help, someone to walk beside through this difficult year, may the Lord open our eyes and our hearts to see the opportunities before us to bring not only an earthly blessing for those in need, but to bring the blessing of life and hope and peace in Christ through our words and witness before others. If we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So whether we live or we die, we are the Lord's. May God keep us in that faith and empower us boldly to share that faith. In Jesus' name, amen. Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds through faith in Christ Jesus to life eternal. Amen.
As a response to today's message and as a response to a reminder of His mercy today, we want to be merciful. We want to give our hearts back to Him. And so I want to share a song that's new to me and new to us. It's called Keep My Heart Tender. This is a prayer song that goes like this.
Keep my heart tender, make my heart pure. I want to be like Mary with that alabaster jar pouring out everything, pouring out everything. Keep my heart open, make my heart true, just like a child. You.
A praise offering to you. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. We thank you, our Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept us this night from all harm and danger. And we pray that you would keep us this day also from sin and every evil, that all our doings and life may please you. For into your hands we commend ourselves, our bodies and souls, and all things. Let your holy angels be with us, that the evil foe may have no power over us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear our cries, and be attentive to the voice of our prayers, O Lord, for the sake of Jesus Christ, the Son of David. Have mercy on us, strengthen the faith you have given to us, and heal us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, you have appointed us as priests in your kingdom, not to offer dead works out of our own weakness, but to offer prayers and living sacrifices made holy, innocent, and unstained by the once-for-all service of Christ, our High Priest. Enable every follower of Christ to be constant in prayer and good works, since our Savior always lives to make intercession for us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Thwart the powers of evil that threaten our world, O Lord of hosts, and protect our nation and its leaders in honest service for the good of all people here and around the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are suffering in mind, body, or soul, the sick and those in need, including Charlotte Calliott, Gus Rodine, and John Williams. Be present with them. Bless them with your comfort and peace, and grant them healing according to your good and gracious will. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promise, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
It's that time for our closing song again as we give him the glory. Help us, Lord Jesus. Jesus, fill us with your spirit as we go into the world this week. Help us to be your light and your salt. Help us to show your mercy and grace. Amen.